A convicted felon who was given a second chance at a life of freedom squandered that opportunity and is now behind bars, charged with murder. In 2013, Stoney Marcus Rivers was a career criminal spending the rest of his life in prison under Washington State's three strikes law, thanks to a hotel room robbery he was convicted for in 1996, according to Oregon Live. That's when Democrat Governor Christine Gregoire stepped in during her last days in office, the Seattle Times reported. Gregoire commuted Rivers' sentence so it would end in January 2015. After his release, Rivers served 2 years on community supervision. Trending, Obama pretends he's president, copies Trump's Asia visits 2 weeks after Donald returned. He must not have changed his ways, though. The Times, citing court records, reported that Rivers is accused of the November 2 killing of 24-year-old David Cabrera, who was shot in the face during another hotel robbery on November 2. Rivers also faces second-degree assault charges for pointing a gun at Cabrera's girlfriend while threatening to kill her, according to the Times. Kent Police Chief Ken Thomas said surveillance video showed Rivers leaving the scene. "We believe it was Mr. Rivers that pulled the trigger," Thomas told Cairo. "We certainly know, if Mr. Rivers' sentence wasn't commuted, he wouldn't be out of custody and he would not have committed that crime," he added. "That much is obvious. Why are liberals obsessed with giving dangerous people second, third and even fourth chances?" Related, Huckabee calls for drastic Lois Lerner action. Former President Barack Obama did the same thing, which ended up with similarly disastrous results. In the Rivers case, the Times reported that senior deputy prosecutor John Castleton wrote in charging papers that Rivers continues to commit crimes, even when he is on community custody and even after being given a once-in-a-lifetime second chance through a governor's commutation. It seems as though Rivers does not care about the lives of others or even his own. If convicted, Rivers faces a life sentence, according to the Times. The man he's accused of killing, of course, won't even get that. HTUK Daily Mail. Please like and share this story on Facebook and Twitter and let us know what you think should happen to Rivers. We strive to the highest conservative values, editorial standards, and truth in journalism, all of which are under attack. Your donation funds the fight against mainstream media corruption and helps us reach millions of readers with the truth. You can also receive the unfiltered truth directly to your inbox by clicking here to subscribe to our newsletter. We can also alert you to breaking news if you click here to sign up for notifications. And, to ensure Conservative Tribune is in your Facebook news feed, mark Conservative Tribune as follow first. Click here for follow first video instructions. Sincerely, Josh Manning, Site Director, Conservative Tribune. What do you think about commuting sentences of convicted felons? Scroll down to comment below.